Holly blow through carburetors. Today we're going to talk about the vent tubes. Do you need them? Yes. Why do you need them? I'm about to explain it to you. Everybody, including myself at first, assumed that the fuel pressure rise was solely to compensate for the boost rise. It's not necessarily true. That's not the whole story. So the vent tube vents the fuel bowl itself. And if you were to rise the fuel pressure through the needle, that is only compensating for part of the equation. The second part of this equation is that when air rushes down the intake and down into the fuel bowl, it will allow pressure on the back of the jet, therefore pressurizing the fuel going down into the carburetor. The problem a lot of people have, including myself on this last experience that I've been through, I didn't have vent tube extensions. I didn't know I needed them. Nobody told me I had to have them, and I had to find out the hard way. So the factory vent tube extensions, or the factory vent tubes in general, they just stand straight up. And the problem that I found out was the air rushing over 90 degrees was causing more of a vacuum effect on the fuel bowl. I have a pretty good demonstration on how to show you guys, and when I get back in the shop, I'll do that. So, as 1 pound of air comes over top of that vent, it doesn't actually pressurize the bowl. I mean, it does to an extent, but the rushing volume of air passing by it will create a vacuum, and even though you have fuel pressure coming in as it needs it, the pressure will actually drop, to my understanding. I'll explain it to you through the demonstration. There is a fix for it, vent tube extensions. There's a lot of people out there that's been doing it for years this way. Now I'm going to show you why. For a lot of people, it's common knowledge, but for vast majority of people out there like myself, I didn't have nobody to explain it to me. I'm learning as I go, and I want to explain this stuff to people. That way they don't have the troubles I've had. I've kicked a rod, I've rebuilt a whole new motor from ground up, only to flood it down with a stuck fuel jet because my fuel pressure went sky high on accident. I'll explain that later. So it's cost me two motors at this point. One of them was catastrophic. I don't want this to happen to you guys. Had I had somebody to make a video like this to explain it, probably wouldn't have made the mistakes I've had, but you learn from your mistakes, and I'm fine with that. It just sucks it costs so much money. So that's the purpose of this video, as I want to explain it as simple as I can. Everything I learned from the power valve channel restrictors, how the power valves work, the vent tube extensions, how I'm doing my fuel jetting. There's a lot of things that I'm learning that I want to explain to you. Now, I'm not professional. I'm really not. Everybody knows that. I don't try to be because I can't be. I'm going to explain this stuff to you the best way I can, the way I would want it explained to me.
It's hard for me to explain things sometimes, so I'm going to do the best I can. This is going to represent your fuel and your fuel bowl and your holy carb. This is going to represent your vent going to the bowl. The way they come factory, they're fine for nitrous or NA applications. You know, the vent doesn't matter. They can be cut off flush, they can be long, it doesn't really affect it. With a blow-through application, there's a reason you see the vent tube extensions, and that's what I'm trying to explain to you right now. So, with the carb hat going to the top of the carb, the air is rushing at a 90 degree angle, or sometimes up, depending on the type you have. And the air doesn't exactly push on the fuel the way it should. In my application right now, I have a little short vent with no vent tube extension. And as the boost increases, or even actually at 1 psi or more, I start losing fuel pressure in the bowl, the fuel curve goes off the chart, and I can't make pull. discovering this was hopefully the best thing for me. People have been doing it for years. I don't know why I never even thought about it. So what I'm going to explain to you right now is when air rushes across that vent, if it doesn't go directly into the vent, the air pressure coming in above the carburetor cannot push on the fuel the way it should. So I'm going to demonstrate what happens when the air rushes across the top of the vent and doesn't go straight in. So you won't be able to hear me, but you'll see what's going on. So, as you can see, the more air I put through it, the more fuel it actually sucked up out of the carburetor bolt. So how do we fix that? Well, we aim this into the wind. So if we aim it into the car mat, what happens? So now the air pressure pushing in will actually push on the fuel bowl. Therefore, the fuel in the bowl would be pushing on the power valves and the jets. So now we should have airflow into the fuel. So the length, I don't see that having a longer one or a shorter one would make a difference. I haven't tried it yet. People do say there's a difference. You should be able to reduce the size of your jet dramatically because this is going to be pushing on the fuel on the jet, making the jet seem bigger. Even though you have a boost reference fuel regulator that rises 1-to-1 with fuel pressure, that doesn't actually have fuel pressure on the jet. That only has fuel pressure feeding the bolt. So once the needle shuts, when the bolt's full, there's no pressure in there. That's where this comes into play.
Oh,